My father had a Randall knife. My mother gave it to him when he went off to World War II to save us all from ruin. Now, if you've ever held a Randall knife, you know my father well. And if a better blade was ever made, it was probably forged in hell. My father was a good man. He was a lawyer by his trade. And only once did I ever see him misuse the blade. Well, it almost cut his thumb off when he took it for a tool. While the knife was made for darker things, you could not bend the rules. Well, he let me take it camping once on a Boy Scout jamboree. I broke a half an inch off trying to stick it in a tree. Well, I hid it from him for a while, but the knife and he were one. And he put it in his bottom drawer without a hard word. There it slept, and there it stayed for 20-some-odd years. Sort of like Excalibur, except waiting for a tear. My father died when I was 40. I couldn't find a way to cry. Not because I didn't love him, not because he didn't try. Well, I'd cried for every lesser thing: whiskey, pain, beauty. But he deserved a better tear, and I was not quite ready. So he took his ashes out to sea, poured him off the stern, and then threw the roses in the wake of everything we'd learned. And when we got back to the house, oh, they asked me what I wanted. Not the law books, not the watch. Oh, I need the thing he's haunted. Oh, my hand burned for the Randall knife there in the bottom drawer, and I found a tear for my father's life, all that it stood for.